My dear student, in previous class already did the turn velocity in displacement time graph, and in this example, what is the comment and on this given graph? For this we take two points here, P and Q, and we know that in displacement time graph, to get the vectorial direction of velocity, we draw the tangent, and so here this tangent represents the velocity of a body at point P, and it will represents the vectorial direction of velocity at point Q. But on what basis you can say either velocity is VQ is greater than VP, or the velocity at point P is greater than VQ? It is very simple method. How can proceed this type of graph? At first we draw the axis, and which is parallel to the time axis, and we have two points here, and so two axis which is parallel to the time axis is drawn here already. Now it makes an angle, this tangent makes an angle with this axis, let us suppose that theta 1, and this angle let us suppose that theta 2, and clearly here theta 2 is greater than theta 1. In this graph clearly theta 2 is greater than theta 1, and hence tan theta 2 is also greater than that of tan theta 1, and we know that already the magnitude of tan theta will represents the velocity, and here theta 2 is greater than theta 1, and so the value of tan theta 2 is greater than tan theta 1, and so the velocity at point Q is greater than velocity at point P. So my dear student, just you can throw the answer against this graph, because here angle goes on increasing order with time, and hence here the velocity goes on increasing order, and so this graph represents the velocity of a body goes on increasing order. Similarly, in this example, we draw the time axis and position, and we take this graph here, and here, and two points P and Q. Now we draw the tangent again, and we draw the two horizontal axis which is parallel to the time axis, but here theta 1 is greater than theta 2. We see here the theta 1 is greater than theta 2, and so tan theta 1 is greater than tan theta 2, and so the velocity at point P is greater than velocity at point Q. By the help of this graph, and we say here the velocity of a body goes on decreasing order. No. Here theta 2 is less than theta 1. That is, theta 1 is greater than theta 2. In this graph, theta 2 is greater than theta 1. And so the velocity at point Q is greater than at point P. But here the velocity at point P is greater than that of Q. And so, because with time its velocity decreases here, and so this graph represents the velocity of a body goes on decreasing order. And hence, by the help of this concept, we can solve any problems which is related to this graph. In third graph, we want to show. In third graph, let us suppose that time axis and position, the line which is parallel to the time axis, and we see here the time of a body, time goes on increasing, time can never be negative, time can't stay, but the position of the body is remains same, and so the displacement, in displacement time graph, the line which is parallel to the time axis, that will represents the body is at rest position. The line which is parallel to the time axis in position time graph represents body is at rest position. Various graphs we have, and just do practice. Now I will deal in further topics the term acceleration. Acceleration, it is defined as the rate of change of velocity, and by the help of velocity time graph we get the acceleration of a body. For this purpose, when time is plotted along x-axis and velocity is plotted along y-axis, now a graph is obtained we have, and this graph is said to be velocity time graph. By the help of velocity time graph we get the acceleration. Similarly, we take the graph and two points are considered, P and Q here. We draw the two perpendicular lines as here, and it will represent V1 and it will represent V2. V1, that is velocity of a body at point P, and V2 the velocity of a body at point Q, and time T1 and time T2. We draw the shortest line and we draw the perpendicular line. Now it will make lattice angle and theta, and so it will represent V2 minus V1, and that is delta V, and T2 minus T1, that is delta T. Delta V, and that is change in velocity. Delta T, and that is change in time. So by the help of this triangle, here we can write tan theta will be equal to delta V upon delta T. And so also we get the value of tan theta delta V upon delta T. The rate of change of velocity, delta V upon delta T, that means the rate of change of velocity. And as according to the definition of acceleration, it will be defined the term acceleration. So in velocity time graph, we also the acceleration can be expressed as tan theta. Tan theta will be equal to del V upon del T. Hence, acceleration, it is symbolically denoted with a small letter A, and delta V, V2 minus V1 upon T2 minus T1. And so the acceleration can be expressed as according to this formula. A will be equal to V2 minus V1 upon T2 minus T1. My dear student, time can never be negative, because time is always positive. And so the T2 is always greater than T1. But during this situation, either V2 is greater than that of V1, either V2 is less than that of V1, and either V2 is equal to V1. In three cases, acceleration of a body will change. And if V2 is greater than V1, so then acceleration will be positive. Then acceleration will be positive because it is greater than that of this term, and so the whole term will be positive, and hence the solution is positive. Acceleration is positive. That means the motion of the body goes on increasing order. But if V2 is less than V1, then acceleration will be negative. My dear student, negative acceleration is said to be retardation. Hence, with time, it will represent the motion of a body goes on decreasing order. But time changes and velocity doesn't changes. In this case, it will be equal to zero, and so acceleration will be zero. So either body is at rest position or moves with uniform motion, the acceleration of that body will be zero. Thank you very much. My name is Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, Woodbine Modern School, Aralpatti, Ganga Sagar, Darbhanga. And just let's see you and do practice hard and wait for further videos. Thank you very much.